Joe is holding this rotating wheel as shown, and he twists his wrist to the right. Which way does the wheel move? So in this situation, the wheel is turning like this, and he takes his wrist and he twists them to the right, okay? So we start off with the equation for impulse and angular momentum. Here it is. So the first thing we do is define L naught. So we, you know, wrap our fingers in the direction of rotation, and so we see that L naught is like this. And then we need to get the direction for the torque impulse. So we take our pencil out. I'm going to use this bar for demonstration. Take our pencil out on the exam. And he's going to take his wrist and rotate like this. Right? He's rotating his wrist to the right. Okay? So the bar is rotating to the right. So you take your right hand and you just curl your fingers in the direction that the bar is rotating, and the thumb is down. So that means that the torque impulse is down, like so. So this is tau delta t. Okay, so you remember that we said, I'm going to put this off to the side so we can draw the vectorial sum. Remember we said that the angular momentum, the initial angular momentum always chases the torque impulse. So we could just, you know, do the vectorial sum like this, but look, it's going to go down like this because it's going to be chasing this direction. Okay, so this will be the direction for L final. Okay, so the answer is down. Let's verify it. Let's see. We've got this spinning wheel and okay, it's rotating. I'm going to twist my wrist to the right just in an instant. I'm just going to give it a torque impulse and see what happens. Okay, so I'm just going to twist them to the right, and you see that it goes down. Okay? All right. Try it out. See you next time.